My dear 8th graders, the day has come to promote you to 9th grade. That's right, high school. While some of you may feel overly ready to go, others may not feel ready at all. It's okay. You're ready. And with a little hard work and determination, okay, maybe more than a little, with some hard work and determination, your high school career will be wonderful. My dear, dear 8th graders, you will always have a very special place in my heart. For the last few years, you all have been like a part of my family. We spend our weekdays together, and on the weekends, I find myself thinking of you quite often. At the store, I'm wondering what kinds of foods and treats you'd all like. At places like the Library and Science Center, I find myself thinking how much you all would enjoy learning and exploring the different things there. On weekends when I'm out in nature hiking, I'm hoping you are out enjoying the sunshine and fresh air too. You are my first class, and I have been so very blessed to get to work with you and know you all so well. It is a truly bittersweet moment I find myself in with all of you. I want so, so very much goodness for each one of you. Please know, I have a very special place in my heart and I have so much love for all of you. This world you're growing into adults in is much different than when I was your age. And it isn't even the same world that we met in for your 7th grade year in 2019 of August. I don't need to tell you that things are much different. Indeed, things are much different. We have come through together, through all the online, offline, quarantine, virtual, in-person, remote learning. We did it. We came through together. You have persevered through one tough year. You have stuck it out through the good and the bad and everything in between. You should feel very proud of yourself and all your accomplishments. I do. I want to thank you all. Rowdy 8th graders, you have probably taught me more than I've taught you in these last few years. Thank you for all the lessons, no matter how hard or challenging. I will keep all those lessons in my heart and I will cherish them and keep them in there, and they will help remind me of you all. Hey, people change people, right? Thanks for changing me for the better. And I hope I did the same for you and that you'll continue to do that for others. I have 4 points and I will keep them quite short. I have marker in my hand, excuse me. 4 points. 1, try new things. Within reason, of course, right? This will help you discover what you like, or more importantly, what you don't like. And you'll get to meet people you otherwise may not have got to know. 2, show up for yourself. Show up for yourself and show up for others. You get to decide who you are and what's important to you. 3, be prepared. It will help immensely, just the way your mental attitude is. It will help you so much. So please be prepared. I'm not saying it's going to be easy in high school, so make sure you're prepared. And this might be the last time, but please listen that I get to say this. Do your homework. Be prepared. Be ready. It makes learning so much funner. It really does. 4. This one is really important. I want you to remember for always and forever, okay? You are missed, you are supported, and you are loved beyond measure. On behalf of myself, everyone in Oak Creek School, and in your Verde Valley community, congratulations. You have done it. On to your next adventure of high school. To end, I want to share my favorite saying. It's an Apache blessing, and you know, if you've been in my class, you've probably heard it. But may it go with you and help remind you of the natural world around us, how connected we are to and how connected we are to each other and to nature. May the sun bring you new energy by day. May the moon softly restore you by night. May the rain wash away your worry. And may the breeze blow new strength into your being, so you may walk gently through the world and know its beauty all the days of your life. You're going to do great. I'm so excited for you all. Congratulations.
Hello, class of 2025. It's crazy to think how close that year actually is. The last 14 months has been time that will be remembered throughout the world and history. It has been a year of trials for all of us in different ways. And this, as we meet right here, is a big accomplishment. But let us not forget the lessons we have learned over the last year. Now, did you know that an alligator is so ferocious that it can kill a lion? But I, Whitten Armstrong, can kill an alligator with my bare hands. How do you ask? They say that to kill an alligator, you kill it right after it eats. Because right after it eats, it gets satisfied and goes into a state where it's almost paralyzed. Are some of us paralyzed? Are we satisfied with the success of standing here promoting to high school after one of the toughest years in recent history? As we celebrate, let's remember not to be fully satisfied. Let's be hungry for more. Now, we all know who Superman is, but in the stories, comics, and movies, do you know where Superman grew up? Not many know the name of the small fictional town in Kansas. He grew up in Smallville. He was known as Clark Kent in his early years and learned many life lessons in a small farming community with open fields. Kind of like here in Cornville. But here's the thing. He didn't become Superman until he moved far away from Smallville, taking with him the love of his family, his school, and the lessons he'd been taught. Clark moved to a big city where he became the man he was destined to be. What does this story tell you? This story tells us to seize the opportunities given to us. Clark Kent saw his potential and seized the opportunity through his struggles to become the hero who we all know as Superman. Let's take every opportunity out there to be successful. I want to see you graduate with me in 4 years. I want to hear that you started your own business. I want to hear that you graduated college. I want success for each and every one of us, but we have to stay hungry. The opportunities are endless, but we have to be able to recognize them to grow to our full potential. Our teachers at Oak Creek School have given us the tools to be successful. They've guided us and sometimes carried us through a year that was stressful for everyone. They made things happen and opened opportunities to keep us hungry. What will we do with these opportunities? The author, Napoleon Hill, who studied the builders of America like Carnegie, Rockefeller, and Ford, and helped catapult Americans out of the Great Depression, said this: "Whatever the mind can conceive and believe, it can achieve." There's lots of things that aren't real because they haven't been done, but the high-speed internet wasn't real 30 years ago. And neither were cell phones. No one had ever flown until December 17th, 1903. Man had never walked on the moon until 1969. No one had ever thought the world records could be broken except for the people who are breaking them. We need to keep going. We don't quit. We finish what we started. The only thing that quitting teaches us is that we didn't finish. So keep running. Eighth grade is just one step. Let's take the next step. Let's take the next 4 years in high school, the next 10 years, and the next 20. Let's keep running and attacking each opportunity before us. Don't be satisfied with today. Let's stay hungry and seize every opportunity. On behalf of the class of 2025, I'd like to say thank you for everyone for being here tonight. Thank you to all of our teachers we've had throughout the years. Thank you to our families and friends who have helped us grow. Thank you especially to Ms. Hador, Ms. Schumacher, and Ms. Alanya for carrying us what seemed impossible at times this last year. Thank you, Oak Creek School, for giving us the opportunities and memories. So remember, class of 2025, remember us. Remember how far we've come, and stay hungry. Go out there and seize every opportunity. Thank you.
Kai Cholton, I believe I first met you out on the VVS soccer field during a British summer camp program when you were probably about 8 years old. You were an absolute go-getter then, and you're still one today. I believe that when you decide there's something worth working for, you have the ambition to get it. My quote for you is, "He who is not courageous enough to take risks will accomplish nothing in life." Muhammad Ali. Kai, take some risks, carefully, and I know you will have many accomplishments.
Hi Zoe, it's Mackenzie. I just wanted to wish you luck at high school. I am definitely going to miss seeing your smiling face around Oak Creek's campus, but I'm so excited for you to experience all that high school has to offer. You are such a resilient young woman, and I know you are going to do amazing things. Remember that you have so many friends and family supporting you, and we are cheering for you and can't wait to see what life brings for you. We love you. Good luck.
Witten, you are a wonderful and polite young man. I hope that you have a great high school career and reach every goal you intend to achieve, and I'm going to miss you so much.
I had the honor of getting to know this young lady this school year. She will be missed greatly. She is a strong leader and will do great things in the future. I got to know Nicole this year playing volleyball in after-school clubs. It was a blast. Nicole was a great role model and took all the younger girls under her wings. We spent a lot of time together. I will never forget some of these memories, like when you would look up and read information about Harry Potter characters, or every time there was an odd number, you and I would warm up. We would pepper back and forth, and we sure got warmed up fast. I also loved how excited you got when you and I would play against everyone else, or when we played beach volleyball in my classroom because of weather. We practiced our jump serve all the time, and you would tell me you could not do it, and then magically it would happen the next serve. I can go on and on. Nicole, you are a talented young lady both athletically and academically. I will miss your smiling face around campus. I will miss you shouting across campus to tell me hello. You always put a smile on my face. I am so proud of you and how much you have accomplished. I know you will continue to achieve great things in high school and beyond. Congratulations, Nicole.
Charlene, aka Sherman. When I first met you, you were a quiet, shy girl. I soon learned there was a whole other side to you. You have a strong, determined attitude that's going to take you places. I'm excited to see what's in store for your future. I wish you all the luck next year.
Over the last 3 school years, I have come to know and adore this young lady. Zoe Mangus has brought a special light to Oak Creek School, and she will truly be missed. She has a heart of gold and wisdom beyond her years. Her ability to lead by example and remain true to herself is inspiring. I am sure that she will go on to do amazing things in her life and continue to impact those around her in a positive way. Congratulations, girlfriend. You're forever my favesies.
Miss Shelby. Hi, sweet girl. You made it. Yay, you're going to high school. I'm so glad I got to know you. You are spunky and funny, and you make me laugh, and you always have a witty remark to say. So I'm fortunate that we got to hang out as we did. If there was one piece of advice I'd have to give you is be yourself. Yourself is amazing. And high school is difficult. But you are capable. And you're going to do fabulous things. So just remember to be you and try your very hardest. And good luck, sweetheart.
Hello, everyone. This is Mrs. Morrison. I could say nice things about every student graduating this year, and I would like to genuinely congratulate all the eighth graders on their accomplishments. The student I chose to talk about is Mika McFarland. Mika, as her teachers and fellow students know, is an extraordinary artist. She has been an after-school art club member for several years now. Mika is also an accomplished reader. And at one point, she was reading her way through the Wings of Fire series of books. Which brings me to my favorite memory of Mika. Now, I am sure my favorite memory is not the same as Mika's. But to me, it illustrates her passion, commitment, and fearlessness. A few years ago, Mika took a star role in the art club's talent show skit. She created an 8-foot-tall prop with a beautiful drawing of a dragon on it. Then, on stage, from behind her drawing, dressed in a full dragon costume of her own design, she emerged to perform in a dance routine to the song Girl on Fire by Alicia Keys. And if that is not extraordinary and amazing, I don't know what is. Mika has come a long way from her quiet, shy self. I see her now always being encouraging and kind to others. I really will miss her presence at Oak Creek School. Congratulations, Mika, and thank you for being yourself.
Elijah is multifaceted. He is inquisitive, investigative, creative, independent, but also a team player. His humor and love of life rub off on people, and he has a heart the size of Texas. Elijah, you have been a joy to have in class, and you have grown so much in the few years I have known you. Elijah has many things he is good at, including cooking and baking, being outdoors, playing sports, and goofing with friends. Elijah was our school spelling bee champ, also placing 5th in Yavapai County. Elijah was a valuable member of the first Lego League robotics team here at Oak Creek, helping program, build, and take the robot to competition, as well as bring the team's innovative community project of 6 exercise stations to the school. Elijah, I know you are going to do wonderful things in your future, and you will enjoy all the new events and possibilities high school will afford you. Way to go, Elijah.
Congratulations, Gabriel Gonzalez. Gabriel, if I had to choose just one word to describe you, it would have to be dedicated. You have an incredible work ethic, whether it's in the classroom or on the soccer field. Every day, I am inspired by your drive and determination to always give 100%. And it's evident that your dedication goes beyond academics, beyond athletics. You are dedicated to the people around you, which is so evident in the incredibly strong friendships that you have. Keep giving it your all, Gabriel. I can't wait to see what you do.
Do you know anyone that always keeps his or her cool? Well, that is how Diego is. He is cool under pressure. It is impressive how collected and together he always is. I have never seen him get nervous like most other people do. He is a person that you know you can definitely count on. In First Lego League Robotics, last year he was a definite team player that worked hard and helped take the team to state. Diego works hard to understand concepts in class and not just get the work done. He also works to keep strong friendships with those he respects. Diego, you are on your way to amazing things. I am sure going to miss you.
Abby Tatum. I recall a spunky young girl walking into our 5th grade class along with her best bud back in 5th grade, and what do you know, the same 2 young ladies have been sitting together each day in our language arts class this year. Abby, you have a brightness about you that lights from within. You are going to crush it in high school. My hope for you, and really for all of our eighth grade team, is not that you keep learning, but that you keep wanting to learn. Be engaged each day in whatever you are doing. Ask questions. Be involved. Stay friendly and kind and helpful. Continue to hold on to that fifth grade spirit, and you will soar gracefully through life and truly live your dreams. My quote for you is, "The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams." Eleanor Roosevelt. Abby, go make your dreams come true.
Congratulations, Christian Molina. Christian, what a pleasure it has been to work with you this year. I can honestly say, without a doubt, that you are one of the most even-tempered, courteous, respectful young men I have had the privilege to work with. You are so well-liked by your peers, and it's because they, too, appreciate your calm, quiet, and compassionate nature. Thank you, Christian, for your hard work every day, for your positive attitude, and for being the glue that really kept us together this year. I wish you all the best in all your future endeavors.
Will, thank you so much for helping me in PE. You were always there to ask me right in the beginning of class if I need any help. I really appreciated that. I know you're going to be successful in high school, and I know you're going to reach your goals. Good luck to you in the future, and I will miss you.
Congratulations, JC Holt. JC, even though we wear masks, I can honestly say that you have a smile that lights up a room. You have a contagious positive energy and a can-do attitude that I greatly admire. You are the fun organizer, always ready with a great idea to bring people together and celebrate things, big or small. I am continually impressed by your openness, honesty, and your integrity. I look forward to hearing about all the exciting things that you are doing in high school. I know you will shine.
Oh, Monty. Monty is the kind of student that makes you want to pull your hair out and hug her and cry at the same time. Put your feisty attitude towards great things and you will go far in life. I'm going to miss you next year. Remember, I'm always here for you if you need anything. Good luck next year and the years to follow.
Brianna, it was such a joy to have you in PE, especially when we would play Quidditch, because you gave me 110% during that time, and all I ever saw from you during that was a smile from ear to ear. I'm so glad to have met you and have you in my class, and I know you will be successful in high school, and I'm going to miss you. Good luck.
Levi has entertained me so much this year. Being a remote student all year long brings so many challenges, and it helps immensely that Levi has brought laughter to our email conversations. Personality shines through even in quick discussions or chats that we've shared. Levi portrays a strong yet calm and thoughtful attitude even in the shortest conversations. Levi has told me about being interested in foreign languages, which shows me the inquisitive side that Levi keeps hidden away. Levi, I hope that you explore learning new languages and follow your curiosity. You are going to do amazing things. I can feel it.
Destiny Velasquez, I will miss your gentle spirit. You have an imagination inside of your head that I know is wanting desperately to burst forth and be displayed onto paper. I have seen you working through frustrations and come out shining and successful. I have no doubt that you will work hard in high school, you will make lifelong friends, and you will be smiling at your next graduation. I have truly enjoyed being your teacher, and I look forward to hearing about your next accomplishments and successes. My quote for you is from Albert Einstein. Your imagination is your preview of life's coming attractions. Destiny, let your imagination come to life and keep shining.
Congratulations, Mason Davis. Mason, I have so enjoyed having you in homeroom this year. Even though you did use all my pencils and hamsterized most of the papers, But no, in all seriousness, I love your sense of humor. I love that you can have fun and take a joke, but you know when to buckle down and get the work done as well. You are a down-to-earth young man, and I am continually inspired by your great love of the outdoors and family. There is no doubt in my mind, with your work ethic and resourcefulness, that you will excel in high school and beyond. Way to go, Mason.
Aaliyah, I remember teaching you in third grade. You were my teaching assistant who would often help check in homework and assist me in taking attendance. You loved helping. You have grown into a kind and caring young lady, despite all of the challenges that you have faced. You once made a comment to me this year that you weren't smart enough. I want you to know that you are enough. You are smart enough, you are brave enough, and as you go to high school, you will face challenges from Mingus head on, and you will meet them and overcome them as you have always done in your life. I cannot wait to see the brilliant young lady that will graduate Mingus in 2025. Remember, you have a loving family who supports you and is cheering you on. I am always cheering you on. If you ever need me, I'm only a phone call away.
If I could have had a daughter, I would have wanted her to be just like Audrey. She is kind and helpful and oh so caring. While I only got this year to know her, she has left a warm spot in my heart. I wish you all the blessings this world has to give you as you move on to high school. I know just from this year, you will do amazing things.
Bud, you are a force to be reckoned with. You are strong and determined. I will miss our little talks we have every morning in the office. Good luck next year.
Angelina, you always made me laugh. Your personality is amazing. I know you will go far because you have the motivation and the will. And I hope you have a great high school career, and I'm going to miss you.
I'm here to congratulate Jeremiah Libby. I had the pleasure of being Jeremiah's English teacher last year at OCS. These are the things that I will remember of him. His wit, humor, and kindness can make anyone's day brighter. Congrats on your promotion, and best of luck in high school.
Kata Aronson. It has been a roller coaster kind of year, but through it all, Kata always has something positive and interesting to say. Though she was new to the school this year, she has fit in so well that it feels like she has been with her class from the start. Kata is our 8th grade student council president, and though student council didn't get to do as much as normal years, Kata has had so many great ideas and different ways to approach things. She's a very kind person that knows how to make things happen. Kata works hard on most everything she does, including academically and her relationships. They are very important to her. Kata has so many beautiful attributes, and I'm so glad I got to know her and had her in my homeroom this year.
This is Mr. Panel, Ali. Just wanted to congratulate you on your graduation, your accomplishment, and I hope that I've been able to help you with the guidance and counseling I've been able to provide for you. Hope that you get all the help that you need going into high school and beyond. And I hope and pray that you'll have a peaceful and prosperous life, Allie, for you and your family. Take care. Bye-bye.
Sebastian is an amazing young man. He is a model student. He is polite at all times. He works hard in classes. He is helpful and kind. But the thing I love the most about him is his sense of humor. Sometimes I never know what he will say next. Sebastian, never change. As you go on to high school, I know you will do great things. It is who you are. Go take on high school and know you will be missed here.
Hello, Miguel. This is Mr. Panel. Just wanted to congratulate you on your graduation. We're all very proud of you, man. And like I said, my friend, I'm always here for you. When you're in high school, when you're in Mingus, if you ever need to talk to anybody, I'm still here for you. And again, I'm very proud of how you're being able to work part-time and to focus on schooling. I think that you're making very good choices, Miguel. So I hope that you keep making those good choices, and I'll look forward to talking to you in the future, okay? Take care.
Jocelyn, always remember you are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, smarter than you think, and loved more than you know. Keep pushing. Don't give up. I wish you the best of luck next year and all the years to follow.
Congratulations, Lizeth Landaverde Romero. Liz, you are a lovely young lady, inside and out. It has been amazing this year to see your creative and artistic side really start to shine through. You are someone who cares deeply for others and whose quiet confidence is admired. Your kindness and your great patience have not gone unnoticed. Liz, you will be so missed. Congratulations.
Hi, I am honored to pay tribute to Noemi Gonzalez. I have known Noemi her whole life. I was fortunate enough to have her older sisters. And then when Noemi came along in 2007, she just added to the family. So they have been genuinely known as my Gonzalez family. Noemi stands out as the most kind, compassionate young lady that I have ever met. She truly and genuinely cares for everybody that she meets. She's always willing to give a helping hand, and anybody and everybody is always her friend. She finds kindness and goodness in everybody she meets. Not only is she a kind person, she's an intelligent young lady, and she always gives her best in everything that she does. And I just wish for her the very best in the near future, and good luck in your next adventure, whatever high school you go to. And keep being who you are and be proud of who you are, because you're an amazing young lady. It's been a pleasure.
Diana, you're an amazing and wonderful person. I enjoyed having you in my PE class. You never gave up and was always working hard. I know you're going to be successful in high school, and I know you're going to reach your goals. Good luck to you, and I'm going to miss you.
Jose Pera, it has been an intense year for all involved, but Jose has navigated things very well. Jose is a very intelligent person that has some incredible friends. In class, when no one else remembers or knows the answer, I know I can ask Jose and that he will probably have a pretty good idea. He has a fun sense of humor, as I have never seen him let things get him down. It has been so nice having Jose in class and getting to know him. He is a kind person that doesn't let others push him around. Great job on a topsy-turvy year, Jose. I'm excited for your new high school adventures.
Hi, my name is Miss Debbie. I have the pleasure of speaking about Mixley Bahina Terencio. I have known Mixley since she was a baby, and then I got to be her very first teacher in preschool. I have watched her grow from a tiny little girl who cried every single day of preschool into a smart, beautiful, confident young lady. Mixley, if I could wish one thing for you, it would be courage. Courage to leave our little school, go out into the world, and become anything you want to be. Good luck in high school, and never forget where you came from. We all have faith in you and can't wait to see where life leads you.
Cade, I was fortunate enough to have you as a fourth and fifth grader, and now an eighth grade student. I remember you and some of the other boys being totally engaged in problem solving how to make a magnetic levitating train. You persevered, and your team was successful. I know that if you continue to persevere through challenges as they arise and continue to flash that smile of yours, you will succeed in all your endeavors. My quote for you is, "What lies behind us and what lies before us are small matters compared to what lies within us." That's from Ralph Waldo Emerson. Keep smiling, Cade.
Have some fun with it. Your bestie says she want party, so can we make these flames go higher? Talking about hey now, I go, Ane. Chucking more feet out, Anane. Chucking more feet out, Ane.
My grandma and your grandma sitting by the fire.
just wanna stay in the sun where I find. I know it's hard sometimes. Pieces of peace in the sun's peace of mind. I know it's hard sometimes. Yeah, I think about the end just way too much. But it's fun to fantasize on my enemies who wouldn't wish who I was. But it's fun to fantasize. Oh, 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 oh. I'm falling, so I'm taking my time on my ride. Oh, 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 I'm falling, so I'm taking my time on my ride. Easy to say, we have a list of people that we would take. A bullet for them, a bullet for you, a bullet for everybody in this room. But they don't seem to see many bullets coming through. See many bullets coming through. Metaphorically, I'm the man, but literally, I don't know what I do. I'd live for you, and that's hard to do. Even harder to say when you know it's not true. Even harder to write when you know that tonight there were people back home who tried talking to you, but then you ignored them still. All these questions, they're falling like, who would you live for? Who would you die for? And would you ever kill? Oh, 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 I'm falling, so taking my time on my ride. Oh, 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 I'm falling, so I'm taking my time on my ride.
Too much.
I've been thinking too much.